So one of the most common questions and statements I get about Stadia is what big games are coming to the platform? What can we expect out of this service? And while all the major platforms don't see many major releases in the first months of the year, and mixed with the fact that things are happening around the world that games are being delayed left and right, it does make you wonder, when will we see some big AAA titles coming to Stadia? Well, in this video, we're going to highlight all the major ones that are confirmed. We have about a dozen or so, then another dozen with heavy rumors or have already been rated for Stadia. All that in this video, guys. Make sure you're subscribed by hitting that red button. Join the fastest growing Stadia and cloud gaming community in all of YouTube. Also, like and hit that notification bell. So let's rapid fire most of these games, since a lot of you guys know what they are about, especially since they are some of the bigger franchises that we know. But we also have a mix of completely new ones like Riders Republic. It's a new franchise that describes itself as a massive multiplayer sports game that has 50 players competing against each other at the same time, while there is other modes like Trix Battle Arena that features 6v6 competitions. Unfortunately, this game had a release date of February, but ended up seeing a delay to an unknown date. Then sticking with Ubisoft, we have Far Cry 6, the next game in the series that has you playing as Danny Rojas, a guerrilla fighter trying to topple the evil Castillo and his regime. This one is played by Giancarlo Esposito, and while details of this game are still pretty scarce, we were supposed to see this game in February as well, but unfortunately it got hit by yet another delay, which admittedly Stadia had a lineup of some pretty big titles that were supposed to come early 2021, and these were two of them officially confirmed, so that is definitely a bit of a bummer and has left us with a little bit of a drought. With that, we have upcoming big games with official dates. FIFA 21 is set to come March 17th, and while this one is coming a bit late, it is indeed one of the ways you can play a high-quality football/soccer game via mobile or other cloud gaming ways, and that in itself, guys, is a highlight. Then April 1st, we have Outriders, a game mixed between Destiny 2, Gears of War, and other titles, and this game is set to have Stream Connect, a Stadia-specific feature that gives you the ability to see other teammates while in a party, as shown here in the Ghost Recon Breakpoint clip. Now, this feature will only be on Stadia, and the game features crossplay with other platforms, so you won't lose out playing with your friends in other places. Now, Humankind is a new franchise that has a Civilization inspiration and is one of the games that I'm most excited for this year. Again, this one's going to have state share. This is another Stadia specific feature and lets you share a save point in my own version of that game and then let someone else take over that scenario. This game is set to release on April 22nd, and just a day after Humankind releases on April 22nd, another big title in Judgment Remaster is headed our way, and it brings the Yakuza spinoff to our favorite cloud gaming platform, bringing in refined visuals, 60 FPS gameplay, and faster loading times than the original. This one is set for April 23rd. Then from here, we have confirmed Stadia titles, but no release dates just yet, and a game that I'm truly excited for here in Chorus by Deep Silver. This is a fast-paced dogfighting game featuring a full-fleshed-out story, a single-player-only experience, which these days we don't see much of, and that for me raises the expectations in a good way for a great story. Dirt 5 is also supposed to come any day now, as the developers have officially said that this title is all but done on Stadia, and what has become somewhat of a meme now is a title that we are all still looking forward to, and that is Mafia Trilogy. This was officially confirmed via their own website to still be headed to Stadia, but guys, there's been no release date and no word, and the game's now been out for quite some time, so I do hope that we see this at some point. With that, there is still also two EA games scheduled to come to Stadia, but we aren't sure what those could be. Could it be the new Battlefield title, or potentially Mass Effect Legendary Edition, or simply just FIFA 22, or even Madden 22, or another sports title, UFC, NHL? We aren't sure yet, but those are still scheduled to come to the platform. So now pivoting to games that have been rated for Stadia, while a rating doesn't technically mean it's coming and it's not an official announcement, in order to rate a game, it actually costs the publisher money. So you don't typically see a rating unless there is a plan. But some games to highlight here that are bigger games has to start with, of course, Rainbow Six Siege, a competitive multiplayer experience that I think we are all craving for. Also, Rainbow Six Quarantine could also make an appearance since it was listed on Ubisoft's website some time ago, but it was taken down once it was highlighted. Then we have the Darksiders franchise. This has also seen some ratings on Stadia, the older Borderlands title like Borderlands 2 and Borderlands the pre-sequel. Then we're going to jump into games that have been rumored in some way, shape, or form and have appeared in relation to Stadia somehow. Here we have Resident Evil 7 and Resident Evil Village. Now, this was leaked last year that showed Stadia paid up to $10 million for it to appear on the platform. Then we have a GTA 5 remastered that has also now appeared a couple of times, one from a prominent website that covers all things Grand Theft Auto. They got wind of this game being made for Stadia alongside a PS5 and Xbox Series X version. Finally, some other games that have also been rated or rumored to highlight. We have Middle-earth Shadow War. This appeared on their own website with Stadia written in their terms of service. We have Football Manager 21. This one isn't shocking to see rated all across the board, considering Football Manager 20 has been around since pretty much when Stadia launched. So all in all, just going off this entire list in this video, you guys can see there's quite a few games to look forward to, but quite a few games that have seen delays. And really, guys, that's to be expected with the current climate in the gaming industry. Also, some things that I want to point out, I personally still hope to see announcements for some other big titles. I'd love to see the Call of Duty franchise, maybe No Man's Sky, or even the Blizzard titles like the newest Overwatch or Diablo 2 remastered, or even Diablo 4. I suspect we will see more announcements of bigger games on Stadia, but since these games do tend to be bigger in scope than indie games, they take a bit more to cook in the oven and to see them on the platform. So for the most part, I have to say patience is going to be key. With all that, let me know down below which of these games that I've mentioned in this video that you guys are most excited for. Also, I want you guys to do me a favor, share in the comments which games you hope Stadia announces so those at Stadia headquarters can hopefully see those and get these games on the platform. And of course, the community and the potential outreach that you guys do does make a difference. Like always, guys, if you're new, please subscribe as I provide nearly daily Stadia and cloud gaming content. I'm Sunny. And I'll see you in the clouds.